This is BBC One in the Northwest. Hello again. That reminds me, I wonder when Come Dancing's coming back. Well, anyway, next week's late film moves from the Greek islands to the Kenyan bush, where an expedition to find uranium comes under attack from saboteurs. The Syndicate is the late film at the later time of 11:35 next Friday evening. But now, tonight's regional news roundup, and most of the victims of the Dan Air crash in Tenerife will be buried at a mass funeral service in Manchester on Monday. Meanwhile, a memorial service was held today at St. Anthony's Church in Wythenshawe. Today's service was attended by civic dignitaries and air crews from the airport. Another memorial service will be held at Manchester Cathedral at noon tomorrow. The biggest ship repair yard left on the Mersey is to close with the loss of 250 jobs. CBS Engineering, which has yards in Liverpool and Birkenhead, says it's been running at a loss for the past 3 years. Still on Merseyside, another 10 dockers were taken to hospital after a second cloud of poisonous gas in 24 hours covered the Northwest Alexandria dock. The men were loading the chemical bromine aboard a Chinese freighter when a 1-litre bottle broke open. Yesterday, 60 bottles fell from a forklift truck and 25 dockers were affected. A 30-year-old unemployed man was remanded in custody at Barrow, charged with the murder of Mrs. Mary Crook. Trevor McCarter, who's single and lives in Cook Street, Barrow, will appear next Friday. The Lord Mayor of Liverpool, Mrs. Doreen Jones, this afternoon laid the foundation stone of the new BBC radio station on Merseyside. Radio Merseyside, one of the first local BBC radio stations, has long outgrown its cramped accommodation in Liverpool's Sir Thomas Street. The new building, costing more than £1 million, is due to open in 18 months' time. Manchester Crown Court heard today how Manchester United fans attacked a Leeds supporter, kicking him on the ground and breaking his nose. 21-year-old John Churm of Castleford was jailed for 12 months, and 19-year-old Anthony Bray of Alexander Street, Salford, was sent to a detention centre for 6 months. They denied causing grievous bodily harm, but were found guilty of assault. Judge Desmond Franks said people were sick of such senseless, mindless violence. After the 13-week steel strike, the main union involved, the Iron and Steel Trades Confederation, has cancelled its annual conference, which would have been held at Douglas in the Isle of Man in June. An official said it was still recovering financially from the strike, and there was a feeling that if the conference went ahead, much of the time would be taken up with recriminations. The public inquiry into plans to turn Wast Water and Ennerdale in the Lake District into big new reservoirs has ended. It's been one of the longest inquiries in British legal history. It lasted 57 days and heard evidence of more than 2 million words from 66 witnesses. No recommendation will be made until the end of the year. Now to sport, and tonight's soccer in League Division 1, Nottingham Forest 1, Everton 0. Finally, cricket, and at Old Trafford a fine victory for Lancashire. They needed 262 runs in 285 minutes to beat Worcestershire, and they got the runs with 4 wickets to spare, thanks to a century by Bernard Reedy. At the finish, he was 110 not out, and Simmons was 53 not out. Lancashire gets 16 points, and Worcester 5. Yorkshire beat Nottinghamshire by an innings and 47 runs, and Northants beat Derbyshire by 2 wickets, with only 4 balls to spare. Northants were 324 for 8 when the game ended. Well, that's our news and sport. On now to the weather forecast. And it'll be fine overnight, with temperatures falling to 4 centigrade, 39 Fahrenheit, with a touch of ground frost in sheltered places. There'll be a good deal of sunshine tomorrow, although the Isle of Man may cloud over later. Many parts will become rather warm, with afternoon temperatures near 17 centigrade, 63 Fahrenheit, but the southerly wind will freshen and become strong at times over exposed western coasts and hills. And that's the forecast. Well, it can't really have escaped your notice that tomorrow is, of course, FA Cup final day. Sad to say, none of our Northwest clubs are in the match, but there'll still be a lot of excitement, no doubt, for soccer fans everywhere. BBC Television's coverage starts in Grandstand, which begins 50 minutes earlier than usual at 11:30. There'll be all the latest news from the hotels at which the teams are staying, a look at how the teams won through to the final with clips from previous matches, interviews with the managers of the teams, and one or two surprising contributions from John Cleese, John Bird and Mike Yarwood. That's all in the run-up to the match itself, which of course begins at 3 o'clock. So the best coverage round of the 1980 FA Cup final right here on BBC One, beginning in Grandstand at 11:30. And for a roundup of tomorrow's sporting action as it affects our region, as well as the rest of the day's Northwest news, Richard Duckenfield and I will be here at 5:45 tomorrow afternoon with the Northwest's news and sport. But for tonight, it's time to wish you a very good night and an enjoyable weekend, and leave you with a look at this week's selection of viewers' slides, sent in to me this week by Mr. G.B. Craig of Littlecroft, Kirby in Furness, Cumbria. And he calls his sequence A Year in Lakeland. Very nice they are too. If you're there on your own just now, well, as always, keep smiling, and an extra special night night to you. Night night, God bless. finally, a reminder that BBC Radio 2 continues now with music and conversation through the night. BBC Radio 2 on 693 and 909 kHz, 433 and 330 metres medium wave, and 8891 VHF in stereo, as well as on your BBC local radio station frequency. Don't forget to switch off your television set now, will you? Good night again.